Children, good morning. Now we have to go for the second poem, A Poison Tree. Already I taught the poem, you know what is the content? It's regarding anger. If you develop the anger, it will grow like a tree. That is not ordinary tree, poisonous tree. Based on that, we have to go for the question and answers. In page number 38, warm up. That is generally you have to think over and you have to give your ideas regarding that. Options are given there. From the options, according to your mood, how do you feel, that you can write. First one, say, you overhear a friend talking, it's in page number 38. You overhear a friend talking badly about you. How angry does that make you feel? Overhearing, you know. Okay, yeah. So if you hear like this, what you will do? I don't feel angry at all. I feel moderately angry. I feel slightly annoyed, I feel very angry, I feel little angry, I feel furious. You know the meaning of everything. Annoyed means irritated, okay? Yeah. So furious, excited. So you are not expecting your friend is like that. So you just somewhat unexpected it is, furious, okay? Yeah. So what's the answer will be? Suppose if I am in that place, really, the third option is mine. I feel slightly annoyed. So, depends on the lesson as well as generally somewhat generous, no? Our principal madam belongs to that. She said that she will feel, no, don't angry at all. Option one is principal madam's choice, okay? Yeah. So, that is left to you. As we said our views, the mine is what I said, I feel slightly annoyed. And madam says, don't feel angry at all. So, it is left to you. Whatever the option may be, that you can select by yourself. But don't think, just keep in the mind always, developing angry is, it will ruin our life. So according to that, you pick your answers. Whatever answer may be, you don't feel angry with others. Okay? Second and also the same like only, your friend pursues you to take help to prepare for the max board examination. Pursued us means what? He promises, because you feel little bit weak in the max, so you need your friend's assistance. She assured that she will do it. That person does not turn up at all. How angry does that make you feel? So you are expecting him, he has to come and help you, but he is not turning up. How your thing will be? It is, everything is left by you. So generally, everybody over, maybe definitely we feel very angry. Because we got disappointment, it is regarding to the subject. So we feel disappointment, no? I feel very angry will be my answer. You select yours. Third one is, you have agreed to pick up some friends at the railway station. It's given a train station. They are coming to stay with you for a few days. Do you know the meaning of it? Your friend is going to come and she has to stay with you for 3 days. Somebody must go and pick up from them. Okay, yeah. You have arranged with your elder brother, sister to drive the car. Either brother or sister, you ask them to take the car and bring your friends. Then you realize the car is outside, but your brother and sister has gone to work, taking the keys. Car is alone there, they are not gone to pick your friend. That to cause keys also not available. How do you feel? That is your answer only. So certainly, because not only you are disappointed, you and your friend also disappointed, she will be waiting in the railway station. So certainly, I feel very angry only will be the answer. Think over and write. The same like fourth one also, during a get-together. Get-together means what? All join together and share our ideas, everything to us, with each other. Huh? Your friend makes a fun for your singing in front of your friends. You thought your life was fine, your voice is fine, but your friend thinks you need to practice much more. How does that make you feel? That is your singing in the get-together program. You feel somewhat you are singing somewhat brightly, betterly, but your friend said you have to have more practice. That's a comment only we can rectify. So my answer will be, I feel slightly annoyed. So we have to go for question and answers. Poisonous tree warm up is not so important, just it's a discussion only. Now this answer you may expect, so just go through, copy down the answers in the book. Do you argue often with your classmates? Often means what? Frequently. Certainly. The answer is, I do argue, but not regarding personal matters, and my arguments get over very soon. We have the arguments, not about our personal, regarding subjects or something else maybe, but immediately should be what? It get over very soon. Second one, do you forgive them or choose to remain enemies forever? That is, suppose if you have enemies, you just forgive them or you are keeping them enemies till last. Not instant forgiveness. Instant means what? Immediate. It says for some time. How long we remain enemies depends on the friend and the issue. So that is what's the meaning of it. Immediately nobody can forgive our enemies. It will take some time. But remaining time is, that is how long we will keep our angry, that enmity, that should be depends upon your friends. And the matter, what for we are getting the enmity, depending upon the issue. Issue means what? Matter. Regarding what matter you got the angry relationship, that should be there. How long does your anger last? My anger lasts for an hour roughly. Just not more than 1 hour. Within an hour it will be vanished. Now it's in page number 40. This is textual questions, you have to learn. Generally poetic questions are very easy. The two lines they will give, from the line you have to pick the answer. If you know the lesson, if you are concentrated, if you are listening, you can write your own answers also. I was angry with my friend. I told my wrath didn't. Okay, who does I refer to? I refers to the poet William Blake. So, poet name, that beginning letter should be in caps, so just keep in mind. Second one is, how did the anger of the poet come to an end? The poet told the reason of his anger to his friend, the anger came to an end. That is, he discussed, so it is over. And third one is, and what I watered it in fears, sorry, second one is, watered it in fears, night and morning with my tears. What does it refer to? Here it refers to anger. How does it water? It's there itself, you see, in the line itself. It is watered with fears and tears of the poet. Then question number 3. In the morning glad I see my foe outstretched beneath the tree. How did the poet feel in the morning? He felt glad in the morning. Glad I see. So what's that answer? Glad only. Glad means happy. He felt glad in the morning. Who is the foe referred here? The person on whom the poet is angry with. That is his friend only, no. So the person on whom the poet is angry with. Yaar mele avar kovapattaro, that they represent that whom the poet is angry with. The next one is, why was the foe found laying outstretched beneath the tree? The foe ate the apple from the poison tree of anger, so he fell below the tree. And it grew both day and night till it before an apple bright. Who does it refer to? It refers to anger, that is personified to the poison tree. What does apple signify? Apple indicates anger. What grew both day and night? Anger, that is personified to the poison tree, grew both day and night. Then complete the summary by filling the given spaces with suitable words. That paragraph is given in your textbook in page number 40. We have to go for answers only. The first one is anger. Second one is suppressed. Third one is faced. Fourth one is attracted. Fifth one is outstretched. Outstretched means what? Developed. Now we have to go for, this is 5-mark answers. How did the poet's anger with his friend end? The poet expressed his anger towards his friend as well as his enemy. That is, he got anger on both friend as well as enemy. But he specified the differences between two types of anger. That is, one with friend, other one with enemy. He told that when he was angry with a friend, he convinced his own heart to forgive his friend, because his friend, you know. So he's forgiving. Forgiving means what? You know. he sorted out the differences with his friend by expressing his anger to him and by discussing his own points of view with him. Then why he got anger, everything explained to the friend. Even if he was hurt and he knew that his friend had done injustice to him, he would have tried his best to forget the past and end the feeling of vengeance in his heart. In this way, the poet's anger with his friend came to an end. That is, he discussed, even though his friend is hurt by him, by the poet, he realized and he forget it. Vengeance means what? That is, take the revenge. Paiki padi vaangraanga nu solranga paranga. That is vengeance. So the vengeance is removed from his heart because both are friends. Okay. Next one is, describe how his anger kept growing, how it is developed. The poet confessed means what? Agreed that when he was angry with his enemy, he did not reveal his anger to his enemy. Did not say. He feared that if he expressed his anger to him, his enemy would do harm to him. He may harm him. So he suppressed his anger. Day and night, he shed tears thinking about the ill or the injustice that had been caused by his enemy to him. He was thinking over how the enemy gave the trouble to him. Thus, he watered the tree of anger with his tears, allowing the anger to grow. He also aroused his anger with his false smiles and cunning tricks towards his enemy. He never expressed out. Okay? He was hiding everything. Since the poet kept his anger within himself and had his own fear and tears, his anger kept growing every day. These two questions you have to learn thoroughly. And third question also, they describe the effect of the poisonous fruit on the enemy. The poet, William Blake, revealed his anger to his friend and the anger ended. But when the poet concealed his anger from his enemy, concealed means what? Hidden. The anger grew. It grew like a tree that bore a bright apple. His enemy saw the shining apple. Even though he knew that the apple belonged to the poet, he wanted to have it. Because he is showing enmity, so what's the result will be? The same thing only will reflect to you. What you give only will come back to you. So the poet show the enmity, so this enemy also show the same thing towards him. So the enemy came secretly into the garden when it was night and ate the apple. In the morning, the poet's anger changed into gladness when he found the enemy outstretched under the poison tree. Here enemy is referred nothing else, that is anger. Anger only represents as enemy. The apple in the tree of the anger symbolizes the poisonous effect. Next one is that poem appreciation is given within the box, you see, in page number 41. Alliteration. Pick out the alliterations in the poem. Pick out at least two instances of alliteration from the poem. From the poem you have to take. What are the answers these? I was angry with my foe. Here what is the alliteration? Alliteration, I said in the very beginning, the same words, that is same letter repeated twice or thrice in one line. Here was, W. The same like with, the starting letter is what? W. So this is one alliteration. Underline both the words. Was with. They are the alliterations there. Next one, night and morning with my tears. So here, morning and my. Morning begins with M and my also begins with M. Third one is, and I send it with smiles. So, sunned as well as smiles, both begins with yes. Till it bore an apple bright. Bore bright. So, underline the words, what all started with the same letter, they are alliterations. And next one, the same line. Read the following lines. From the lines only you have to take down. I was angry with my friend. I told my wrath didn't. I was angry with my foe, I told it not, my wrath did grow. So what's the question from that? So you have to depend, you have to get the answers from the lines what is given there. Pick out the rhyming words. What is the rhyming word? friend, and underline the words foe, grow. Next one is, what is the rhyming scheme of the stanza? That is, the stanza is given the that four lines. Friend, end, both are what? A. And foe, B. Grow also what? B only. Because both same pronunciation, though the spellings are different. How do we pronounce friend, end, foe, grow? The same spell sound. So we have to write, first two are A, second one is B. So while writing, you have to write A, B. Third one, identify the figure of the speech of the little poem. Title of the poem. That is, we know, anger. Anger is personification. Anger is not a person. We just imagine them as a person. So it is personification. And I watered it in tears, night and morning with my tears. What figure of speech? The same one only, personification. And next one we have to see, listening. That is, match the following line. Meditation is definitely a great technique. Second one is, there is a person living inside you. The dashes you have to complete. That is, one side is A, you have to consider one is A, other one is B. From the B, we have to pick the answer. First one, C one is the first answer. That is, meditation is definitely a great technique to calm your inner self. Second one is, there is a person living inside you who always tells you how to act. That is conscience. Getting angry is natural, but to know how to handle is a virtue. Anger is something that releases the tension. Option is A. We will take care of the reason why you got angry. The last one, close your eyes and speak to yourself and calm yourself. So, first one is C, second one is C, third one is B, fourth one is A, fifth one is D. Children, two more things are given there. That is, answer the following in about 80 to 100 words. That is just for discussion only. You no need to learn. And the other one also discuss and write that and all, just to develop your knowledge. You no need to, and just go through once enough. So what are the things you have to go through? 80 to 100 words and poetic lines. That's all, nothing. Okay, thank you, children.